Do you love to mountain bike, but lately you find that your hands are going numb, or it feels like you're losing grip strength? Mountain biking can be a lot of fun, but it can also lead to certain injuries if you're not set up properly. So stay tuned and find out the measures that you can take to prevent this from happening to you. Click the subscribe button and hit the notification bell so you'll know when new videos are posted. We had a question from one of our viewers about mountain biking. And of course, if you have a computer and you have repetitive strain injury from that, it could also carry over into the other things that you do because you can't use your other pair of hands to do the things that you like in your leisure time. So here to tell us what sorts of injuries could happen from mountain biking or perhaps other sorts of biking is our chief medical expert, Dr. Robert Markison.
Well, this literature came about in the 1970s looking at all sorts of neuropathy, meaning usually nerve compressions related to cycling. 60% of distance cyclers will have neck, spine problems in general. That's a high prevalence, high incidence. And then the question is, what happens in the hands? And so the more vulnerable nerve is called the ulnar nerve. It runs behind the funny bone here, and it goes out to here, and it gives you feeling little in half of the ring. But more importantly, it gives life to 15 out of 20 small intrinsic muscles in the hands. So the classic compression is when you're leaning on that nerve and you start to get an ulnar nerve palsy, which is weakness here. And the ulnar nerve can contribute up to 40% of grip strength, but you can lose dexterity, have the loss of feeling or sensory loss in here. The good news is that with some backing away from too much cycling and padded gloves, proper bike setup, handlebar configuration, these things usually go away. It's relatively rare, quite rare, that I have to operate on these ulnar entrapments at wrist or elbow level in cyclists, because most of them go away, and the studies confirm that, including prospective studies. The studies have found no significant difference in the incidence of ulnar nerve or other compressive neuropathy between mountain bike and road bike. And so they're similar, but changing your hand position on the handlebar is a good idea. If you have vertical end bars, then you get out of this, go to this. If you're not in some potentially dangerous immediate braking situation, you always want to be towards here as opposed to here and weight bearing. This is much better than this, and a nice light grip whenever it's safe to do so. Good idea.
And what about that posture of the neck? Sometimes I see cyclists and they're very rounded over, or maybe forward head. Do you think that's important as well, Dr. Markison?
Well, it is, especially given up to 60% prevalence of spine problems, including neck, lower back, and so on in cyclists. So unless you're in some kind of speed race timed situation, you're always better to be upright, because 3 inches forward in a facial plane can sometimes triple the forces going through the spine. A lot of spine decisions are made in the womb, because when you're a fetus, the embryology is getting out of that curvature and getting upright. But a lot of people are born and live a good life with kyphosis, head forward. A lot of people lead a good life with scoliosis, S-curve. Kyphoscoliosis, both. Scoliosis, 10 to 15% prevalence of sometime in the life, radiculopathy, nerve problems from the neck to the upper limbs. That's compounded with a head forward posture. And so, yes, upright is good, too forward is bad.
And one last question. When you're talking about the ulnar neuropathy, is that what they mean when they say handlebar palsy?
Generally so, because the more common is the ulnar nerve, but the median nerve can also be aggravated. So you can have a totally numb hand. But the carpal tunnel is less vulnerable than the ulnar tunnel, and it's the deep motor branch of the ulnar nerve that gives you all that wonderful intrinsic power and dexterity, small muscle stuff. Be very careful. You don't want to put much weight on that. Enter powered, padded gloves and change in hand positions, and never over gripping anything.
So no extra weight on the...
No extra weight.
Okay. Thank you, Dr. Markison, once again, for enlightening us about biking.
Sure.